Hello, Minecrafters, and welcome to episode 21 of our Let's Play Infinity Evolved. And I also wanted to say real quick, Merry Christmas, everybody. Yeah, no happy holidays here. I'm a Christmas kind of person. And what on earth are you doing watching videos on Christmas? Yeah, okay, I'll probably do it too, but anyways. I have been working on a few things, and I have learned something about immersive engineering. You see how they're all nice and pretty and blue? Well, I actually had to make a modification to my power setup. Now, as you can see, this isn't full, but it is a gain of 75 RF a tick right now. I had to change something. As you can see, it's coming from over there as usual, but it doesn't go to there, and it doesn't go to here. It just goes around that way. And here's the interesting thing. As you can see, this is almost all charged. I've got something using a little bit of power, but hardly any. So right now, we are at 75 RF a tick. If I take, and I know for a fact nothing is using this one, but if I take and connect this to here and go over here and look, we're now negative 325 RF a tick. Connect that to there. Negative 458 RF a tick. So evidently, any time you split that line, it splits the voltages in the different directions. Now, like I said, this one goes nowhere. As a matter of fact, we'll do this for science. And I'll just, let's just connect it to there. Okay, 74 RF a tick coming in. Connect it from there to there. Now, it definitely goes nowhere. That's just cobblestone that it's on. Nope. So it didn't split. So evidently it has to go to something that actually has an input. But my thing is, that is already full, so no power can go in it. But yet we tie to it, and it drops it way down. So, gonna have to look at a different way to do our power distribution. And right now, I'm really not sure exactly what I want to do different. I am looking at multiple power. Currently, we're using the ten sets of three water wheels. And I get about 80 to 90 RF a tick off each set. But one of the things I am actually looking at, and let's see, I need to put water in here, and I need to get rid of some stuff, because I'm going to need some room in my inventory. Oh, yes. And this brings up another thing, and that is Botania. All of my plants died. And I looked it up. And apparently now, any passive mana generating plants in Botania, they die. So you either have to keep on making them or make something that is not passive. And what I mean by passive is it takes a fuel source of some type. The nightshades and the day blooms have a limited lifespan. And once you get a certain amount of mana out of them, they dead. They die. They turn into a dead bush. So, this is one of the things I am going to be looking at changing. For now, I'm probably going to go with the Endoflames. Because what I'm looking at is the possibility of turning my tree farm back on and just using logs with the Endoflames, because this was extremely efficient. So I'm thinking about doing that. And it's a little scattered this episode, so I apologize. But this actually came about making these. And I got a few of them made, and when I started making these, that was when I found out about the whole power split cable thing. And so that was interesting. Actually, I need two of these. Take two and call me in the morning. Now, let's see. I had a few different things set up over here. That's something different. That's something different. And that's going to be something really different. Okay, I know what that is. Maybe I never did set up this one. But anyways, one of the things I've been wanting to do is Ender Chest. And this was actually how I ran into the fact that I was going to need machine frames. So let's get started making some Ender Chests, because one of the things I'm wanting to do is to be able to replace my diamond chest here with an Ender Chest. And the reason for that is so that I can also use an Ender Pouch and tie it to that Ender Chest. And see, these aren't bad at all to make. But then when I'm out and about, I can throw stuff in the Ender Pouch, or Ender Pouch. It will sync up with the Ender Chest, and then that will then go into our sorting system. So, let's get back to our Ender Chest here. Now, some of the things we're going to need are iron chest, wool, that shouldn't be too hard, crushed obsidian. I do know I made some of that. And we'll grab it. And I've got my machine frames. Now, wool. Let's just go with... Don't I have a bunch of string over here somewhere? Yeah, we'll just grab that stack. Now, the reason I wanted to grab my industrial hemp fiber is because it converts straight over to string. And then you can take that and convert it into wool. So now we have plenty of wool. Especially considering I only needed one. Now let's go down here to our metal former. And I've already run some iron plates through there. Wait a minute. I need more. Okay, well, I can make more while I goeth around talking. Alright. So we'll take these, drop them off in here, and let that run. Oh, wait. Well, the capacitors I've got should be sufficient. Yeah, that'll be enough. And if not, we'll rig something up and run power back over there. Alright, what else did I need? Three of those, that. Ender tank frame. So, machine frame, eye of ender. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. It was 4 I needed, right? Yeah. And Enderium Nuggets. That, I believe, might be in one of these chests over here. 4 Enderium nuggets. I'll just come down here to the last one. Do that. And that. And this. And the good thing is that gives you 8 of the frames. So then put that. And what else was it? Oh, the iron chest and the wool. Alright, let's see if those have run through. Looks like they have. Sweet. Now, come over here. Yes, that's way more than I actually needed. But sometimes it's just easier to click on it. 8. Yeah, just like me, come up a little short. Okay, so put that there, take that, run these around, get those, and this should give me my ender chest. So now, let's see, let's grab our little dolly here, we'll pick that up, drop it over here, and we now have our ender chest set up there. So, let's look at the ender pouch again. Ender pearl, some leather, some blaze powder. I know I've got leather around here somewhere. It's just a matter of finding it. One, two, three. Let's see, then I need an ender pearl. And I think it was 4 of those. We'll find out when we find out how much I'm short. I need the wool. What do I want to take out to put back in? I'll take the milk out. And now we have an ender pouch. Now the cool thing about this is since my ender pouch is white, 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 and my ender chest is white, 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 that means all the colors match. So if you'll notice, when I open my ender pouch, the ender chest over here opens as well. So anything I put in it will also be in the ender chest. So you see here it says ender chest, and here it says ender pouch, but their inventories will match. So one of my preferred ways of sending stuff home. And another thing you can do, let's see, that's a blacklist, so that lets everything through. Now let's take ignore NBT, leave that on whitelist or on blacklist, and let's say machine frame. So, if I take, if I take a stack of netherrack, gone. But if I take a machine frame and drop it in there, it'll stay. And you can actually set that up so that things that you, if you mistakenly put something in here, then it won't go through. And it didn't go through anyways because, okay, let's do that again. It didn't have a place to go. So we're on blacklist, ignore NBT, and we'll do netherrack. So now when we drop netherrack in there, it doesn't go anywhere. Now, anything else, like dirt, that has a place to go, it'll suck it right out. But that's a good thing you can do with filters on that. And since I cut that off, it went on. So one of the things that I sometimes do is on the filter, I'll take off the NBT and I'll put my tools that I want to make sure don't go anywhere. And the reason for that is that and that. I don't know. Whichever. Just throw some tools in there. So that way, if I'm out and about and I space click, well, you'll see a few things disappearing. Those are the items that do have a place they can go. But any of these others won't go anywhere. Even if I come over here and let's say, okay, this is done by mod owner. So let's take this and we're going to make this a tinkerer's box too. So as you can see, some of the tinkerer stuff taken off out of here, but you'll notice that none of the things that I put in the filter left. I didn't put that in there. Hey, now wait a minute, that shouldn't have gone. I bet I need the other filter. Okay, belay my last. Let's take off metadata and try that again. Doink, 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 doink. All right. Now, when I put that in there, see, those weren't on the filter. That is. But I told it not to or to ignore metadata. So it doesn't matter how damaged it is, it's not going to go anywhere. It's still there. So just a way to make sure that while you're out and about, if you mistakenly click on things into your bag, they don't go anywhere. And I'm not real worried about those because they're not going to be in my bag that often anyways. Let's see. I don't want it to take that, and I don't want it to take that. So we can put all those in there, and they're always there. Even though Tinkerers and Botania actually have places they could go. Okay. Wow, I'm rambling. Let's look at something else. One of the other things that I'm wanting to look at starting to make is different power access. So I was looking at making a diesel generator. So that is one of the things I wanted to do this episode. And I've got all this stuff laid out, and it takes a whole bunch of steel. And I mean, just a little bit of it. And as you can see, I'm making radiator blocks now. Those will go on the front. And it needs quite a few. Or I'm making too many. I don't know. My luck, I probably figured this out wrong. I did, because I only need 9. Wow. Okay, well, win some, you lose some. All right, and then I need this, and that is going to go in over here, like this, so that I have 28 heavy engineering blocks. Then I want 6 of these generator blocks. And I do still have that. And I need to find a place to put this. And actually, I guess I could put it here. Or do I have room down here? Why, yes, I do. Nice. Yeah, because that wall's right up against it. The only other thing is... Okay, yep, it's within the chunk, so that will work. Now, where's my book? My book left me. Because I didn't have the book on the filter. And I can't quite remember how that one goes together. So, which one did Immersive Engineering go to? I'll probably look right at it, not see it, close it, and move on. Okay, where did my book go? Really? It's in my pack the whole time. Good grief. Mercy. Alright, let's try this again. Let's go figure out how to make a diesel generator. Alright, open the book. And this is the diesel generator. We're going to have the radiator blocks back there. So let's switch to those. The one that happens to be the one I made twice as many as I needed, because it produced 9, or it produced 2 instead of 1 like I thought. And then we're going to put in our heavy engineering blocks. And then, we did have one of those left over, but no real way to get around that one. Then we're going to put that there. We're going to find our little hammer again. We're going to find our little hammer again. There's the wire cutters. Why am I having such a hard time seeing things on my hotbar? Okay, so now here we have our diesel generator. And we can pull power off of these three places here. So what I'll end up doing is I'll take a high voltage line, plug it into this, and go right over there. And that should feed right in with the rest of what we're doing. And I can put fuel in right here. One downside to how I have this set up, and that is the fact that my redstone is not accessible. Now see, this little thing right here, if you put a switch or lever or something like that on it, then you can cut the engine on and off. So, let's take this back apart, and I'm going to turn it around. That's right, folks. We here at the Jim Slate Show do not run on a script. Where'd my cobblestone go? There we go. And close my wall back up. And take my too many radiators. Now that's going to be radiator and heavy, heavy, heavy. That's actually going to run it over there. And get my shovel. My slimy shovel. And let's dig back just a couple. And fill in the dirt hole here. Probably doesn't really matter, but It matters to me. Okay, now we got that closed up. Let's put in our radiator blocks. All 9 of them. Now, take that up, put that there. Yeah, I think that'll turn out a little better. And we'll put that there. Step right through here, grab my hammer. And right click it. There we go. I guess you have to right click on the front. Picky little thing. Alright, and it bothers me that the radiator doesn't have at least an airspace there. I don't know if it matters, but it matters to me, so. There we go. Now, and I don't think we're going to be able to get all this done this episode. We might have to come back next episode to actually cut this thing on. But this is our diesel generator. So we can put in our fuel here. We'll be taking our power off of here. And we can put a lever there or some other type of redstone signal to cut it on and off. And I can get off the grid. Now let's head back up to our little crafting area and see what we got next. Okay, next item up for bids is going to be a pump from Industrial Craft. This is made with electronic circuit, basic machine casing, tree tap, 2 mining pipes, and 4 empty cells. Next to that, we have pipe sealant. Nifty stuff there. And then we have quartz transport pipe. But once we add our pipe sealant to it, we get a quartz fluid pipe. And then down from that, we stuff in our new stuff, and we come out with a Buildcraft factory pump. And then upon my inventory, I should have a drum and 2 transfer nodes. Actually, 2 drums and 2 transfer nodes. Yeah, I think that's all I'm going to need for that. Okay. Then our last item down here is going to be a diamond gear. That's done with a gold gear, which you basically just cast that, put 4 diamonds around it, and you get your diamond gear. And then that diamond gear is going to get stuffed in here between 3 Buildcraft factory tanks and 2 redstone torches to get a refinery. So what we'll do is we need to go find oil. And that is charged because I don't really have a remote way to do power yet. And they're not cheap. One of the ways I usually do it is a dimensional transceiver. And that's going to take an octatic capacitor, an ender crystal, an ender resonator, which makes you have to make with a splice and slice. And maybe we'll do this next episode. Yeah, that might be a good one to do. That way we can have some actual remote power. But for now, let's just knock that out of the floor. Pick that up. And let's go find some oil. And see if by chance I can actually remember how to run that thing. Because it's been a while since I've used one of those. And I thought this might be a good place. And I've actually got, I can come here to my basalt teleport. Or my desert. Let's zoom in over here at the desert one. Let's go to, well,
Oh, I know what that is. That's something else entirely. But yeah, let's jump to our yellow desert and see what we can get over there. And we are already out of time. Goodness. Yellow desert. Teleport. And step out of it. And it's night. Of course. Why didn't I check that before I left? I know better than to go rambling off in the middle of the darkness. And that is what the black thing was. Hey, we got somebody coming to see us. Can I behead them? Let's find out. Make sure I dodge that. Hi, who are you? I'm not sure who you are, but I got your head. Okay, kill you and you and you. Don't be dodging my arrows. Now, whose head did we get? Okay, I'm looking at it and I'm still not sure who it is. Progress sixes. Yeah, okay, I'm really bad with names. Tell you what, it doesn't look like a real good time to be out and about right now. I'm trying to get somewhere that I can have enough time to find home teleport and teleport home. Preferably. Ooh, blizzes. Those are always nice. I have yet. Ooh, good, I jumped it. I've yet to figure out why blizzes are in the desert, though. I don't know. It's just me. Doesn't make sense. Because aren't they, like, supposed to be cold? But yet, you find them in the desert? Yeah, that makes sense. Sure, why not? It makes Minecraft sense. Okay, looks like I've got them all backed off for a minute. Home, teleport, and fall. Take damage. Ta-da, we're home. And actually, I think that's going to be it for this episode. Next episode, we'll see about getting some oil. Oh, yay. I can see through my walls. Gotta love that respawn lag. Okay, everything's loaded now. Alright, well, I think that's going to do it for this episode. Now that we have some daylight, I'll get back out there, see if I can't get some oil. See if I can't get some of this stuff loaded up. Yeah, like I said, get out there, get some oil, get it in the drums, get it back over here, get it processed. But all that for next episode. And hopefully we can look at getting some of our logs from there into some endoflames over here and see if we can't get some mana going on. But anyways, I believe that will take care of it for this episode. And once again, Merry Christmas. If you don't celebrate Christmas, I'm sorry. It's my favorite holiday of the year. It's a great time to get together with family and friends and eat too much, buy too much, and get too much. But anyways, Merry Christmas. Take care. God bless. We'll see you next time.